Hey guys, what's up? So I recently saw this trailer this morning and I just want to break it down to you because there's some really cool things happening here that you maybe missed. So it starts with this very like 80s TV show vibe here, and you can see the kind of text they use, but then when you zoom in the silhouette,
worth the trouble?
You want to keep the lights
they're
on around
both
here?
talking, and this is kind of your first appearance that this trailer's not what it seems like. Because Jet, I'm gonna scroll back. Jet is kind of in one part of the ship. He's in the front of the ship. Spike's in kind of the middle hallway, and she's actually not that far away. She's just one level up. But what happens is Jet pulls back the comic line
You
here,
want to keep the lights on
and then
around
he
here?
goes through. It's actually two different scenes. Because the lighting is consistent, one is shot on the front of the ship and one is shot in the middle.
Where do we
Same thing
find this
here.
dipstick?
So you see the pull away is a transition cut,
We'll
and then
handle
she
this one
fades in.
on our own.
Not a chance.
Not that way.
And here she's like, here the bounty says, there's a bounty out. They're gonna do this on their own, but Faye says, not a chance. That is very on point for Faye Valentine. She's always trying to beat them to their bounty because they work as a team where she works kind of as a solo person. So here's the interesting thing. He pulls back and there's a random person here. So this must be either a scene from the show or it's just a random person. But it could be a scene from the show because it's just like, hey, and they pull out the pistol. He's looking. Here's the dude that was with the coat to the back. He throws a punch and Spike, this is the first time you see Jeet Kune Do from John Cho, so that's interesting. Now, I don't know how I feel about this spinning flip kick that he does here. Yeah, it does look cool in slow motion, but that's not really Jeet Kune Do. Jeet Kune Do is really like smallest movements possible that
I
you
got
can
him.
do.
That's not the bounty.
I got him.
That's not the bounty.
So this is so the thing they did here is a perspective shift where they shoot from Spike over to Faye and then back to Jet. But the cool thing about this shot is Jet is always in the shot. So it goes to Jet
That's not the
and
bounty.
it doesn't go out of
I
Jet
got
because
him.
he's always in the
That's
shot
not the
here.
bounty either.
So it's kind of funny because this is a very like
That's not the bounty either.
comic-y or
I
anime
got
thing to
him.
do where he's just paused until this camera zooms
That's not
on
the
him
bounty
and then
either.
he starts to move again. There again, she's about to say,
Spark!
what the F,
What?
right? And
We're on
that's
a
very on
job.
par with her.
Seriously?
Noodles first.
Again, it's two different shots. So they're shooting one scene here and they're shooting one scene here. And it's two different shots because you see with the way Jet is standing and he's looking, it's kind of the same angle, but not really. So let me play this back and I'll set this to let's do 50%. I think we can do it at 50.
Seriously.
And so it's a slightly different angle, slightly different lighting, but it's barely noticeable. Oh, so the way they do this, guys, it's very interesting. They have a cut here of a dude walking by, and this could be a computer dude, it doesn't have to be a real dude, but he walks by and Jet is in the same place. So it's possible that Jet isn't even in the scene because you see the way Faye is facing as she's looking forward. So they could have shot Jet on a separate green screen. And that's why he looks kind of the most consistent there.
Noodles first.
So with the bounty and with Cowboy Bebop, they always eat really piss poor on their ship. So any chance at food, it's something he likes. So this is cool because when they spin the camera, you're going from kind of a market scene into a preview of Vicious. And if you watch the anime, that's kind of like the main bad guy. They do a split here again.
This way.
And this split is actually kind of neat as well.
He's this way.
Because it is two different shots. So if you look and I pause it here, his hands don't quite line up, right? But when you do the switch, you do see a new scene. And this is very like 1960s vibe with the Technicolor. And they're pushing against each other. And I think this is the most impressive shot so far in the trailer, because they're leaning on this thing. So the way to have him lean, he actually has to lean against something physical. So maybe it's like a green screen wall that they have there. Someone's behind there. So they're pushing it here. Faye kicks it. And Faye pushes it and we're pushed back. Now the way this works and the why this works is because when this guy is being pushed and Faye pushes back, he's overlaying her. So it's a cool technique because since he's the overlay, he can cover exactly where her hands go. So her hands don't have to be precise. They just have to be kind of in the area because his body is covering it. So they say, "Hey Spike," at the same time, and that could be a voiceover. So he grabs this pole, which is the middle comic line. You get the color lines again, like the 80s or the 60s shows. This overhead shot is really cool, but it's also a stunt double. So I want to talk about this transition because he kind of breaks the line here. This guy's head goes down into the line and it folds. So the line is just animation, guys. So you can have one shot here because you see this building's connected. So they're doing a transition to a different shot, but that animated line makes it really neat. Now he steps over the comic line. This is how you do 3D images. You've seen those images online where there's like two bars and then like it looks 3D because one hand's past the bar. Same technique here.
Hey, nut buckets. There's no payout if you shoot him in the face.
So she says, "Hey, nut buckets." She calls him name, and she's usually kind of the meaner character in the show. She's kind of like the tsundere, where she has kind of a tough exterior. That was a great transition. So she takes basically here, and then she doesn't really do anything. So what's happening is the camera's panning behind her head, and then they're able to use her head, since it's black, to transition in this new scene.
Him, please. I got him with three clean slugs in the leg.
I never miss, and I aim for his leg.
Never miss?
Never.
You aim for the face.
I did not. You
now, this by far is the coolest part of the trailer, because you get like this space flight, and there you see the swordfish, right? And overall, you see the bebop. Don't see Spike, or I didn't see the hammerhead. Maybe it's to the side, but it's kind of too dark to tell. But definitely, you can see the swordfish is there. So that's important because the swordfish 2 is Spike's main ship, and maybe we'll get to see some dogfights. That's the hope, anyways. Alright, guys. Let me know how you think of this, and exciting, right? It's coming out on the 19th. I think the anime version's coming out this coming week. So definitely check it out. Let me know what you think. It's very stylized. I do like the fact that they shot this teaser outside of the main show. So that's going to be, if they're putting this much work into the teaser, I hope this much work and production value goes into the real thing. Let me know what you think. I'll catch you on the next one. Bye.